reviewing the secular education system in Israel in these days, as opposed to 30, 40 years ago, we're finding something very disturbing. 30 or 40 years ago, there still were a secular school, public school, that teach secular studies, a little bit Torah, a little bit Judaism. The teachers are not religious. 99% of the students are not religious. So it's basically complete secular school. However, since they taught Judaism in a limited way, the Jewish kids in this elementary and high schools, they had basic knowledge about Judaism, which means they knew who was Moses, who was Abraham, Isaac and Jacob, the tribes, they knew the holidays, they knew a little bit about the Sabbath, they knew about kosher, they knew general things. They didn't know specific things, they didn't know Gemara, they didn't know Mishnah, they didn't know a lot of the Chumash story, but they basically had some idea. Reviewing the system today, 30 or 40 years after, it's so disturbing that it brings tears to our eyes. When you look at the new children in the schools and you ask them basic question, there are kids today that are walking around, they know anything about the Goyish world, about the world of the Gentiles and Hollywood and internet and movies and music and sport, etc. They have no idea even the names of the rabbis. They don't know who was Rabbi Akiva, who was Rambam. Some of them never heard that there was a person named Noah. They don't know about the flood. They don't know about Abraham. They don't know anything, basically. And you see when you speak to them that they have such zero knowledge, and you wonder, where should I start from? So I wanted to tell you a little story about something that happened in Mamash a few months ago. That there's one rabbi who was able until today, to the best of my knowledge, to go every Friday and give 10 minutes speech in a secular public school. Now we have to understand that the reason I'm telling you this story, that this by itself is a miracle, because the principal of those schools will never allow anybody with a beard or yarmulke to come and speak to the children about Judaism. They'll never allow it, because they always will be afraid that it's going to affect us to become more religious, and that's not what we want here. So one, this rabbi is going there every Friday, so his rabbi asked him, how did you manage to go into that school every Friday and they let you speak 10 minutes? How do you do it? So he said, I'll tell you the truth. What happened is, I wanted to go there on Shavuot, the holiday of Shavuot, the holiday that we received the Torah. And I called the principal on the phone and I told her who I am, and I want to come and speak about the holiday of Shavuot. So she said, how long you want to speak? He said, no, a few minutes, just to give him some general ideas about the coming holiday. So she said, well, you know, it's not acceptable so much here, you know, we have to know who you are, you know, try to escape the situation. And he told her, listen, I promise you, all I'm going to speak about is why we eat dairy food on Shavuot. You know, it's a custom, it's a Jewish custom, that in the holiday of Shavuot we eat dairy. So I'm going to explain to the kids where this custom comes from, nothing else. Also, I'm going to tell them that it's the Yortzeit and the day that David HaMelech was born, to talk to them about King David, and nothing else. I'm not going to try to affect them to become religious or anything like that. So she said, okay, come to my office, I want to see who you are. The next day he goes there, and she made him sign everything they spoke about yesterday with his signature that he will not change his plan. 10 minutes she's giving him in front of 400 children. He has to speak about the custom of Shavuot and about King David and nothing else. And he signed, and he promised that that's what he's going to do. They gather all the classes, and now he's speaking, it's 10 minutes. Just before he finished, he told the kids, and now, after explaining to you about the holiday and about King David a little bit, I have just one last question before I leave. Do you know, kids, who is the one who wrote Tehillim, Psalms? Who wrote Psalms? 400 children silence, not one of them knew who wrote the most legendary book after the Torah, it's the Tehillim, the Psalms. Nobody knew. This is mamash a few months ago in Israel. The principal, she didn't know where to hide from the embarrassment. Such thing that almost every goy, a Gentile, knows about it. The Jewish kids in Israel, they have no idea who wrote Tehillim. So he said to them, I'll give you a hint. I'll say the first name and you tell me the rest. David, and everybody screamed, Ben Gurion, like the first prime minister of Israel, David Ben Gurion. He say David, and they say Ben Gurion, and say Hamelech, the king. Now the principal had to go out of the class, from the face was red like tomato. When he came out, he told her, I'm very sad that none of the children knows who wrote Tehillim. This is not about being Jewish, this is about general knowledge, intelligence, education. She said, I agree with you. I mean, I didn't know that the situation is so bad. He said, why don't you let me come every Friday, 10 minutes? He took advantage that she was so embarrassed. And I will speak about general things about Judaism. Nothing, you see, the way I spoke today. And out of her embarrassment, she agreed. And now, since then, every Friday, he goes and speaks for 10 minutes, trying to be like a thief, to teach Jewish children about some of the things in the Torah without getting caught. Maybe it will make them a little bit more religious than what they are. This is the situation we live in today. That's why it's very important to do Kiruv. As I always say everywhere I go, people have to participate and help in any way possible to spread the Torah through CDs, through the internet, through Facebook leads, through lectures, promote, sponsor with money, everyone according to his abilities. If we're not going to do it, nobody will do the job. This is what God expects from each one of us. The Frum, the religious Jews, have a big obligation to bring the secular brothers and sisters and show them the truth, because apparently we already see hundreds of thousands of Baalei Tshuva, people who became religious. If no one would approach them then, they would be still in their phony life, in their life of illusion, not knowing what they live for. That's why it's saving souls. And the Torah says saving one soul is like saving the entire world. Let's hope that my words will go into the hearts of each one of you. And with Hashem's help, we'll have enough time and ability and money to do the job correctly. Thank you.